Jacob, it's your favorite vlogger here. I just wanted to test this out and try and do a voiceover because I know a lot of the vlogs have absolutely no talking and no dialogue, so I wanted to give this a try. Quick note on these next few areas, we did not spend that much time there because the wind was absolutely atrocious. Like, we couldn't stand, so we didn't stick around too long. Car parks were completely full, as always. It was a big pain to get parking. I'll give some advice later in the video on like how to, you know, avoid the whole rush of people. This is actually us heading back to our Airbnb. We drove past Storr, couldn't find any parking, and decided, you know what, let's go do something else and come back later in the day. And that's what we did. Little fact about this castle, it was the former home of the MacDonald clan. Oh, MacDonald had a clan! The house originally was built in 1790, and in 1815, a castle, fake castle, for show, no actual defensive use whatsoever, was built next to this house. In 1855, part of the house was then destroyed by fire and replaced by another wing. So, you know, there's lots of dates going on here with this place. The castle has been abandoned since 1925 and has fallen into ruin. You're not allowed to go inside because it's dangerous. Which sucks, I would have loved to have gone in there. They maintain everything else today, so you can still walk around the garden and see the ruin. And there's also a museum. This room is where they did the laundry, by the way. How high class is that? Laundry house. This walk was amazing, by the way.
Another rest for me.
A note to add here, if you guys don't watch my Twitch stream, I actually injured my knee before this trip and was climbing a 1600 feet ascent with a very bad knee. So, you know, it is doable.
Hear a bee.
Hmm. we're heading up here. Add a note to anyone who wants to do this climb. Firstly, to get to the very top, it is an ascent of approximately 1,000 feet. Probably more, honestly. I don't know. Not a mathematician or a geographer. And you do this in quite a short distance, so it is a very steep climb. There is also a lot of rocks. I even managed to fall myself, so make sure you have the right footwear. All in all, the walk took us about 2 hours, 2.5 hours to get to the top and get back down again. The mountain with a Gemini, gonna fall and die, and then I'll have a funeral for me. Sounds like angry bees. I don't like bees. If you want to do this climb, go later in the day, because we started at about 5 p.m. and it was the perfect time. By the time we were coming back down, there was no people, it was still daylight, and the car park was empty. Another tip for Skye in general is if you're going to a popular place like the Quiraing, Storr, Portree, anywhere, go later in the day if you can and do the less popular things early in the day, because it is almost impossible to get parking on Skye, so just a piece of advice.
And we go
all the way down here and back to the car. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys like the voiceover, please let me know. And if there's anything else you guys would like me to talk about while I do my videos, as in you want more advice, you want me to talk about the area, you want me to tell stories, then just let me know in the comments. Thank you.